Good evening, friends. Welcome to Aware and Care, your weekly medical program, an Ayurvedic perspective to body, mind, and soul with Dr. Ambika Nair, who's the chief consultant and co-founder at Shantigram Group of Companies. And of course, every week we bring a topic and concern that Dr. Ambika Nair helps to understand and helps us to understand the path of recovery. Let's welcome to the show first. Welcome, Dr. Nair. Namaskaram.
Namaskaram. Thank you so much.
Dr. Nair, this body is a mystery. And I'm sure you will say, Madhvi, no more a mystery. We've been doing so many episodes, but by now we should understand what this body is and its functions are. One of the most important aspects of this body is eliminating excess water from the body. And it is a very important function on a daily basis, basically urine. But passing urine is of concern for many people. There are certain diseases, symptoms that create a lot of discomfort to people. Today, we will discuss one particular such symptom or a concern called dysuria. Let's talk about it today to understand what is this problem and how does it happen. Let's start with the basic first question. What is this condition?
This is called a dysuria. Mm-hmm. This means, you know, it is a little painful mixturation. Mm-hmm. People cannot be, you know, like normal people will have a good flow of urine, mm-hmm. but due to some obstruction or any other disease, you know, they will have these issues. Mm-hmm. That is called, you know, dysuria.
And what are the symptoms for it? Is it just pain?
Symptoms will be very painful. Mm-hmm. So actually, it's a very big subject. Okay, painful, burning sensation will be there. Sometimes only drops of urine only will come out. Mm-hmm. They feel like going, the urge will be there, but they will not able to pass it actually. Mm-hmm. You know, like a lower abdominal pain. Some days they will have pain on the thighs also, on the calves also. So this all will be there.
Okay.
Fever also can be there. If the inflammation is there, like infection is there. It mm-hmm. can be because of any urinary infection also. But there are even some pelvic inflammatory disease or any other, you know, like even some trauma.
Okay.
If you hit somewhere and you don't know what happened. Especially this is seen in, you know, gymnastics children and all. We get a lot of, you know, like children comes to me, you know, like so much of, you know, and in sports person also. So they fall. So
let me rewind you to the previous statement that you just mentioned. Because as you were mentioning about these symptoms, I thought it sounded so similar to UTI, urinary tract infection. So let's also understand the difference between these two and men, women, children, who are more affected with the dysuria.
Everybody can be affected actually.
Wow, okay.
Yeah, but mostly, you know, like if it is age related, means in the old age also it comes because they cannot pass. See, especially in men, I will tell. Okay, if their prostate is enlarged, mm-hmm. UTI is there, any cystite is there, okay, any other surgery, consuming a lot of any other antibiotics or any other, you know, like medication for a long time. Mm-hmm. So this all can also occur like that. And sometimes, mm-hmm. you know, like any, I have seen some, you know, patients with severe back issues, like back mm-hmm. pain and all. And in arthritis cases also, they will complain like the dysuria. Mm-hmm.
So how connected is this problem also to the kidney? And correct me to understand more that many surgeries like vasectomy or hysterectomy, does it also lead to the situation, or people do often complain after surgeries about this particular condition?
No, like after surgeries, actually, because if any other mismanagement or anything went wrong with the surgery only. Mm-hmm. But, you know, like hysterectomy, because there can be a possibility overusage of the catheter. Mm-hmm. Use of the catheter also, because ascending infection always comes over there. Yeah, okay. So many cases comes like this. And a repeated UTI uh-huh. and urethritis, any inflammation, okay. even with the stones, if any obstruction on the ureter. So this also can. But you know, like dysuria is a vast subject, and we have to diagnose mm-hmm. what is the real cause for that actually.
Okay, so even to diagnose that, I mean, a human body, there's the idea of this particular program is to come out from the discomfort zone about talking about bodily functions and understand. So Over the years of understanding what is the consistency or frequency of passing urine and what is the color of the urine that a person should notice and then realize that something
it should be straw colored actually.
Straw color, okay.
Yeah, light yellow.
Mm-hmm, light yellow.
Not that very white. Mm-hmm. But you know, yellow color, you see the consistency should be, you know, it should not, some urine, you know, it according to the disease, the urine also smells.
Okay.
Frothy will be there if they are having, you know, even like a sugar also. Easy to understand, you know, like you can diagnose whether it is cloudy, whether any particles are there.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, like when you go for the urine, in like a routine examination itself, you will be able to understand whether you have any albumin, whether the patient is having any other kidney disease, any swelling on the, you know, feet, on the mm-hmm. face also. So everything we had to, whether they are asthmatic, even asthma people will have little dysuria.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah. Have thyroid people.
The connection
because,
there.
Because of the lot of water retention will be there. Mm-hmm. Even endometriosis. So many cases, even heart patients. Pulmonary effusion.
So Dr. Nair, we just mentioned about the color of the urine. Now you also did mention about the smell and the stench. Because of the nitrogen level, because of the foods we drink, eat, or the water we drink, or if you drink less water also, you definitely see a change in the smell of the urine. Sometimes it's too pungent and sometimes it is too fruity, depending on other health conditions. Now, in this particular condition, what is the observation sign apart from the pain when the patient or the person should feel, hey, something is wrong with my urine?
If it is like a high colored urine,
mm-hmm.
if you take B complex also, your urine will be high colored.
Yeah, that's right. Okay.
So don't go for any other further test, you know, like, okay. But see, when we drink water, you know, at least, you know, the excretory organ should work, actually, the kidney should function properly. Otherwise, mm-hmm. lot of water retention. That's, you know, we always see whether any legs are odymatous, swelling is there, any heaviness in the breast, in the chest, I mean, okay. So this mm-hmm. all, you know, like breathing difficulty, how they are able to, you know, whether they are oriented properly, memory is good. And, you know, like they will say, some people will tell that so much of fogginess. Whether it is kapha related, in Ayurveda, we always, you know, diagnose like that, whether it is kapha related, vata related, or pitta related.
Mm-hmm.
So we diagnose them and we then only we will tell that what they should do.
Okay. Doctor, this pain is during passing urine, or they may also have flank pain like kidney pain, kidney stone
no,
pain.
No, if it is like a stone only, like you, they get the hydronephrosis, you know, that backflow will be there.
Okay.
If it is having so much of obstruction,
uh-huh.
okay, then only they will have this backache. Okay, but backache will be, you know, like just under the rib over there.
Like the flank pain it. That is.
Yeah, little, no, it will be a little more painful also. And you may not be able to tolerate it, that much it will be there. A lot of gas formation, acidity, little constipation, all those things, you know, because it can be there actually, if it is related with the kidney. So that okay, is a so, different, yeah.
So in this case, do they also experience blood in the urine?
If there is, you know, like, you know, blood in the urine will come not only in dysuria, because mm-hmm. actually if any other problem is there.
Okay,
sometimes it can escape because if any other rupture is there, the stone is moving. Okay, so the naturally it will rupture a little bit. Okay, so that little, you know, like it'll be there. If the kidney is evolved or any other, you know, like their creatinine level is going high, kidney mm-hmm. patients, then definitely it will be there. Escape mm-hmm. of RBCs will be there.
So, doctor, these symptoms, as an adult, we are able to explain to the doctor, or we sense to observe it, that something is wrong with the body and the way we are passing the urine. Now, when it comes to children, I think it's parents' responsibility to observe it for young children. And you're saying that this can affect at any age group. There is no systematic reason as to why it comes, or it is just the body type apart from the health conditions?
No. Cleanliness.
Okay.
Yeah, because that is more important, actually. See, mm-hmm. you know, like, you, first of all, you know, what you should do, you have to drink a lot of water. How to prevent dysuria?
Okay.
Now you diagnosed, you have a dysuria, you have mm-hmm. issues, whether you have uric acid, whether you have any other, you know, like, any other issues. So mm-hmm. the doctor, you know, like, how you can take care of yourself, that is more important. Drink a lot of water. It mm-hmm. flushes the urinary tract.
Mm-hmm.
Some people, you know, they are very lazy.
Mm-hmm. And fear of public toilets also is one of the public restrooms.
No. Madhavi, I have seen that because I have some clientele, you know, they are very religious.
Mm-hmm.
So if they pass urine or stool, they have to take whole bath. So okay. They will never take the, you know, like they will never drink water much. And they come with so much issues. I will tell that no religion told not to drink water actually. Because I read all these three religions, you know, like, but nobody told, you know, not to drink water. And it's really pathetic and they will never listen. Wow. Only one glass of water in the morning, one glass in the evening. Because in between, they don't want to waste their time for taking bath.
Okay. So how does this particular problem, does it become gradually or it just comes overnight?
No. Some people, it will come overnight if you have any other inflammation. You understand?
Okay.
So, you know, like, then, you know, like, sometimes, you know, like, so much of discharges will be there. Purulent discharges will be there. You know, like, before bed, you are supposed to take, you know, like, you have to go to bathroom to urinate, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Clean your private area properly. Mm-hmm. After the intercourse, cleanliness has to be maintained. When the ladies will get the periods, you know, like keeping the pads for longer hours without changing, because, you know, see, working condition also we have to see how they are. Mm-hmm. Okay, so these all, you know, because actually they will get repeated UTIs.
Okay.
So that definitely they will fall sick like this.
And, so today we're talking about this condition where painful urination, to explain in basic terms, but there are a lot of other factors, like Dr. Nair just mentioned, that it's a vast topic and there could be various subsequent reasons why this particular condition is happening. And after they rule out all those, they come to the diagnosis part of it. And what kind of tests are done to confirm that the person is suffering from dysuria?
Ultrasound is done for the kidney and the urinary bladder, and the urine test is done. And the culture is done.
Culture is also done. Okay.
Yeah, because they will see that whether they are, you know, like, because repeated, you know, because they will be given, nobody will come just like that, no, dysuria means. They will come, you know, like after taking so much of antibiotics, etc. You know, after hysterectomy, you were right, actually, because sometimes, you know, because it can affect the bladder a lot.
Uh-huh.
So that vata, first of all, you know, they will be a little afraid.
Uh-huh.
So if anything, you know, they get afraid.
Okay.
And especially during this pandemic. So, you know, like a frequency of, you know, like anxiety will also lead to like a frequency of urination.
Mm-hmm.
So that is also one of the reasons.
Okay. And Doctor, you did mention about, you know, after intercourse or periods or, you know, cleaning your private parts. Now, how does this interfere with STD? There is a misconception, there is a talk about it, that this and STD go together. Is it true? Is it not true? Or
definitely, if you are having like a multiple partners, so then you have to use the, you know, like precaution actually.
Okay.
Yeah. You have to use the French leather, you know, so that you don't get any inflammation. See, even for AIDS, people like that only.
Okay.
So any sexually transmitted diseases, you have to be very careful. See, single partner means, you know, like the chances are very less. But only thing, single partner, it is applicable for both of them.
Okay.
Not that only one is, you know, like taking care, the other is enjoying life with multiple partners, means that is a big question.
Absolutely. So today we are speaking about the subject of painful urination dysuria, and we've just spoken about all the basic factors that lead to this. Now let's get onto the doorstep of Shantigram and understand what happens, how is this condition diagnosed, and what is the treatment course. Now let's start by knocking at the doorstep of Shantigram. Doctor, a patient with dysuria has entered the clinic. What next?
First of all, history in these cases.
Mm-hmm.
What was their personal life?
Mm-hmm.
Whether it happened after the deliveries, did they use any, you know, catheters for a long time, any surgery was done, any other inflammation they had, any medications were taken, how many times they have taken these antibiotics and like all these courses, how many years, some people, whether they have any other diseases, then be, you know, like in this case, it will be like first that only, then be checked whether they are, you know, related with kapha, vata or pitta, then accordingly we go for the therapy. And, you know, like, actually, you know, like, especially for ladies, means, you know, like, it's very easy for gents also, because so many cases comes to us.
Okay,
so we do it very fast actually.
Okay. Now, doctor,
we educate them also.
Yeah, as I'm asking you the questions, I do understand, and as a very serious conversation where I'm trying to help our viewers and you as a doctor helping the patients, because there are so many uncomfortable questions that are coming forward. And that's exactly what the diagnosis chart has to be, truthful and honest on part of the patient also. Many a times patients do not disclose certain information. They only come by saying that, oh, it just started last week, doctor. You know, they
no,
do not
we understand that. We understand mm-hmm. that. If it is chronic, we understand it actually.
Okay.
Very so nicely, we understand actually.
So the doctor knows best and understands very well as to what the condition is and why that symptom is, at what stage that particular symptom is. So what happens next? Do you also recommend some kind of urine test after they come to the clinic?
No, or they come with all the tests only. Don't worry for that. They will have all their everything ready and they will tell, you know, like then we start giving them, you know, herbal products also. So that, you know, like their urination will become easier.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And first, you know, that we'll see that whether they are able to undergo the panchakarma, whether they really need it or not. Mm-hmm. If not needed, we will give them herbs and diet. Mm-hmm. And, you know, like we give them, you know, like they will be fine. Okay. So counseling is more important because chronic cases mostly come to me.
Uh-huh.
99% chronic cases only comes to me.
And this is a curable disease completely?
Of course, it is curable.
Oh,
but only thing, without their help, you won't see cleanliness.
Yes.
More important. Okay. And their, you know, like, you know, like your day-to-day life.
Mm-hmm.
How long, you know, some people stand for a long time without drinking water. They cannot use the bathroom and all. Then, you know, like, so we have to make them understand what they should drink. Mm-hmm. You know, like what they should, you know, like coriander water, we tell them to use it, lime juice. There are so many things they can take care of.
What is coriander water? Are you talking about the leaves or the seeds?
No, both can work actually.
Both can be taken.
Yeah. And even, you know, like cardamom, especially in the Asian community, we tell them to boil little, you know, like a pinch of cinnamon and to cardamom, small cardamom, little one. So that they can crush and make a water, and it helps a lot. It will really help them to do at home, you know, that they will urinate very properly. Obstruction, only we have to see whether any other obstruction is there, whether any other injury is there.
Okay. So when the treatment has started, the first sign of relief is that they will have started seeing the reduction in pain, or they see that the flow of the urine is...
Oh, the reduction in urination plus, you know, like pain, sorry. Reduction in the pain plus the urination, you know, that the flow is really increasing and they don't have to struggle for that actually. Back pain, they will always tell that severe mm-hmm. back pain. Okay, so that back pain will go away very fast actually.
So we were talking about the treatment courses through Shantigram as to, or Ayurvedic means to cure this particular condition of dysuria. So we were talking about panchakarma. You're talking about something like coriander water. And what else can be done? What else is recommended or done during the treatment?
You know, their diet.
Mm.
Spices, we will not give them a lot of, you know, like red chilies at all. Especially for people from Andhra, we will tell them not to take spice much.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Sattvic diet. Okay. And, you know, they should not take any, you know, like too much cooked food.
What is that?
Too much cooked food.
Okay.
Overcooked food.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So, you know, like the half cooked food, like salads are very good for them. Cucumber is very good. Even, you know, like cauliflower, even though I say not to eat, but here I will tell them to eat.
Okay.
You know, like cauliflower, broccoli, cabbage, all those things are very good. Very, very nice. All those things, you know, like all the whole grains and old red rice. White rice is not good. Moringa is very good actually. Moringa leaves.
Uh-huh.
If they don't eat it, they can just boil and drink the water. Our curry leaves.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful it is actually.
Okay. What about barley water?
Barley water they can use, because I always tell them to use barley water if they have any water retention. So they
but
can use
doctor,
it.
why am I feeling that most of the treatment course or the symptoms is exactly almost same to what UTI is? There must be some difference.
Because right? There are so many, you know, like the diseases actually, whether it is, you have to diagnose it actually. The symptom will be like that only, the urge will be more.
Mm-hmm.
Because you sometimes you feel like going, you will only pee for like one or two drops.
Oh.
And very painful it will be. Burning sensation. I know whole body will burn. And even the soles of the feet will be like a burning sensation will be there. Mm-hmm. We have to see whether they are even diabetic.
Oh, yes. That's a very important aspect there.
Yeah. Diabetic people also will have all these issues.
Mm-hmm. So, doctor, what about patients who are using adult diapers? So, do they...
That's why I told you cleanliness. Actually, because that, see, they are lying down. They cannot go. You know, those people suffer a lot, actually. Very common with them.
Yeah. And that is so connected, no, Dr. Nair, that, you know, maybe they drink less water dryness. Because they're embarrassed to, you know, release. Yeah, dryness, and then if they release, like... they release in the diapers and then the cleanliness. It's all interconnected there.
100%. So, cleanliness is more, and not only that, because the dryness has to be there. Even for the ladies, you know. Mm-hmm. See, when we are healthy, also so many people neglect, actually.
That's true.
So keeping, you know, that area dry. And that's why, you know, like you see in adult nursing homes and all, you know, like elderly people, especially men with, you know, like all the prostate issues, they have a lot of inflammation, you know, that's why they put the catheter and all. Because, you know, they suffer a lot, actually. The ladies also, because we don't know what will be our fate, but we have to be more conscious.
So as part of a general checkup, do you suggest that adults or seniors who are wearing diapers, they should get themselves checked for this? Or
They check it actually. They go for all these, you know, checks actually.
Okay.
Otherwise, they will get into fever, you know, like very much inflammation will be there. Then, you know, scenario will change.
Mm-hmm. So we were talking about the treatment courses for dysuria, and it's a very painful urination condition, and all the other aspects which doctor has mentioned. Apart from that, if you still have any doubts, you must consult the doctor and get complete advice and take rest and medication as per advice by the doctor. Now, doctor, let's also talk about fluid intake. Yes, we do talk about the importance of water, but in today's time, people... drinking water has become out of fashion. We try to drink more of aerated drinks or, you know, something.
I know, aerated drink and all, at that time when they have this problem, we tell them to drink it, okay?
Uh-huh.
Okay, but you know, like the coconut, tender coconut water is very good actually. Mm-hmm. You know, like a horse gram, boil it and drink it, it will come. It will be mm-hmm. very good actually.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like a patola, very nice. Khajur they can eat. Okay. So that acidity will not be there much. That's what I'm telling. Okay. Okay. Amlaki, our ghee, include little ghee in your food, you know, so that will also help you a lot, actually.
Wow, how beautiful. You know, Dr. Nair, I want to share with you one particular incident from one of our viewers. You know, they have been watching the program regularly for last over weeks that we've been doing. One simple thing which happens in Dr. Nair's programs or in the treatment is she is not enforcing any kind of medication. Most of her suggestions are always to do with diet and drinking and sleeping. And I said, well, that's exactly what she's recommending, that your body is healing on its own and you should follow that. What do you want to say about that, Dr. Nair?
You know, like, because unnecessarily, without seeing, how can you tell what to take?
Yes. See,
anybody can take a gokshura. Gokshura is very good if you have a problem like that. Mm-hmm. Using the ginger, you know, ginger juice, mm-hmm. even like a few drops, honey is very good.
Mm-hmm.
So this is all very good, you know, like why I don't tell, you know, like this, because so some others, they can tell, you know, you told me to take all these medications, now it's not working. See, very. Chandra Prabha Vadi, we use a lot actually in such a cases. Okay. Okay. You know, turmeric with amla is used. Mm-hmm. And we tell them, you know, like if they cannot come to the clinic, we give them oil to do the mm-hmm. abhyanga. Okay. Mm-hmm. So, you know, like we have like a very... patients from different parts of the world also.
Yes.
So, you know, like, so after the consultation, we ship the medications and we tell them how to do it, and the follow-up is always done on Zoom, and they really take care.
Yeah. You know, dear viewers and Dr. Nair, despite giving all the natural remedies that Dr. Nair has been sharing here, and like we always mention in the program, please do not try any of these home remedies on your own. First consult. These are very safe do the go use products in every household. Yet a consultation is a must with your doctor or at Shantignam so that the right course of treatment is done. Like doctor just mentioned, sometimes cruciferous vegetables are recommended. Sometimes it's not recommended. You may watch the program from halfway through and just take half the advice. So it is not advised that way. So take the complete course of the treatment and try to heal yourself. What kind of vitamins or any other thing that would you be recommending?
Vitamin C is very good actually. Orange juices they can take, cranberry juices they can take. But only problem, Madhavi, all these juices will work if you are at least better. Otherwise, what will happen? You know, if any obstruction is there, if they are not passing urine, they will land up in ER.
That's true. Yeah.
You know, like Tulsi Kashaya, very nice. It will help a lot. Buttermilk is good. You can always, you know, like drink that actually with your food because it will all cool you. But but the treatment is different. This is all what you can do at home.
Yeah. So fluid intake is a must and in different forms it 100%. Should be taken. And then so that the obstruction is dissolved and apart from that medication is required and treatment is required. When a person comes to a discomfort level, it you know, medical intervention is a must and going to the doctor and getting themselves. Any other final piece of advice that you want to give to our viewers today, Dr. Nair?
You know, carrot juice, carrot with the ginger juice, it's very good actually. Yeah, they can use it actually. But only thing that whatever fluid you take, you see that you urine it also. You have to take it out also. If the excretion is not correct, then you know like so many issues will come.
Right.
Okay, so be careful. Don't keep on drinking water if you are having, you know, like any problem like it is urea. If you are not able to urinate, please go to a doctor. That will be the best way to save yourself.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for today's episode, Dr. Nair. Such a delightful and such a knowledgeable topic. And once again, leaving this show at a point where we feel so much of comfort knowing that most of these conditions and symptoms or discomforts are curable through right diet and sleeping habits and food habits. Thank you so much. I look forward to the next episode with you here on Aware and Care.
Thank you. You always come with a new, you know, like the subjects. Good.
Thank you, doctor. Thank you.
Thank you.